My name is Zeno Muller, Olympic gold and silver medalist. I coach digitally, online, worldwide. People send me footage of their erging, of their rowing on the water, of their sculling on the water. And what I do is I explain in slow motion how they can perfect their rowing stroke. I speak several languages, but for us right now, English is the most important, because today's webinar is about getting recruited for college and how CrashB can help you get there. Now, as I said in an earlier tweet, if you feel fat and happy, figuratively speaking, if you have nothing wrong with your rowing and you're all happy and good and your ERG scores are just beautiful and you're not worried about it, turn this webinar off. I don't want to see you. I don't want to know about you, because you don't need my help, okay? But for those who are in distress, who need to make sure that their ERG score gets better and better because time is running out and getting recruited to college is a mission that has to happen and not mission impossible, I am your person to go to. And this webinar is exactly about that. It's the CrashB. How can you nail a really good new personal best in four and a half months come February? This is what I do. I was born to do this. Some may have think that at first I was born to row a single scull and row an eight, but now I am coaching, and I think I'm a better coach than I was a competitor, and that says a lot. I'm going to show you the Olympic gold medal race
for Slovenia, but here's Zeno, and we're into the last quarter of the race, and the pressure really being piled on. The Canadian on the far side, and Muller, now Switzerland, here he is, and he looks as if he's full of power.
Absolutely powerful on that catch. He's winding it right up, and he's moving. He's moved past Langer. He's almost now onto Derek Porter. Now can Derek Porter wind up that race? Has he got the flexibility? But Muller is moving. 350 meters to go, and Zeno Muller has wound it up. He's moving fantastically well. And he's moved right past Porter. Half a length. In 20 strokes, Muller went right through first and second place, and he's now in front by three quarters of a length.
And he's pulling away as well, and not for the first time, in fact, for the second time in the space of 30 minutes, a Canadian sculler has been asked a serious question and can't respond. In fact, no one can respond. This is enormous now. Muller pulling away. Every stroke he's going further, and look at his face there. He knows he's got this. He's looking to his left there, and he's so strong, the rest can't do anything about it. Porter's being overhauled here by Langer. They've got the battle for the silver and bronze, but clear water, and Zeno Muller striding out for Switzerland. He's not going to be caught. This is a fantastic burst to take the gold medal, and who gets the silver? It's just Porter who holds off Langer for the silver. The German takes the bronze, and the world champion, a distant fourth within... what an amazing gold medal. Switzerland's first gold medal in Olympic competition since 1928.
Okay, so if you have any questions, okay, throughout this webinar, you can email me, zeno@zenocoach.com. Tell me what your story, tell me what you want to be doing. I love hearing from anybody what their rowing story is. So I was recruited to Brown University by winning the CrashB back in 1990 as a junior. And I won my hammer, and I pushed 2,500 meters back then. And I actually set the the distance record for 2,500 meters as a for my category. And I pulled a 7:42 back then, which is over 2,500 meters, something around 132 point something, okay? There I met the late Harry Parker and Steve Gladstone. It's a really great venue to meet people who are coaches in that region. Now, of course, if you live in California or you live anywhere else and it's too far for you to go to CrashB in Boston, that's okay. There are satellite regattas throughout the United States where you can actually join. at Brown University. We won IRA, the NCAA National Championship. We stayed undefeated. Scott Roop was a great coach. Steve Gladstone was our varsity coach, who ended up... he's now the most successful coach in the United States as a collegiate coach. Elite coaching is what made possible for me to go to the Olympics. Because as a 19-year-old, if you don't know how to row, you're not going to out-muscle people who are 10 years older. You can out-row them with good technique. And by the way, I am shorter and heavier than most of my competition. Most of my competition was taller and leaner, and that makes a boat go faster, but not if they don't know how to apply their power properly. This is my coaching tree, okay? My coaching family tree. I am successful as a competitor and as a coach. It comes because the knowledge is passed down.
Reluctantly crouched at the starting line, engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone. All alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance.
But no one is going to challenge New Zealand. Look how they fight back. They're enjoying it. Big smile on the face there of Stroke. They're sitting back there and using all their undoubted power through the stroke. They miss nothing at the beginning of the stroke. They power it right through. It's very simple, very straightforward what they do, but it's so effective.
And their coach, Richard Tonks, should be pretty happy with what he's doing.
Kiwis going for gold. France in the silver medal position at the moment, but surely they have an unassailable lead and nothing should stop Merry getting his gold medal at last and Bond getting 1-2.
But Clearwater and Zeno Müller striding out for Switzerland. He's not going to be caught. This is a fantastic burst to take the gold medal.
Look, the erg is simple. It's one brutal machine. It's going to measure your ability. The better the erg score, the more likely you are to get recruited to a university of your choice. The erg is the SAT of rowing. In order to achieve a personal best, a maximum personal best, it's not going to happen if the knowledge that is given to your son or daughter is not at the very top. Because a lot of coaches, they do not want to know anything else from anybody else, and they will drive and coach and negatively coach your son or daughter and blame them for their mental quote-unquote weakness for not getting a better personal best. There are huge mistakes to commit, and I picked five of them, top five huge mistakes, okay, to avoid. Believing you are not mentally tough, and that is something that you will hear from other competitors, maybe from coaches, where they blame your inability, your son or daughter's inability to improve their erg score because they're not mentally tough enough. For me, someone who shows up every single day at the boathouse and does the workout, and you can tell they're putting effort in, they have the stuff to get the job done. It drives me crazy to think that there's negative coaching, but there is a lot of negative coaching. So for me, the fact that you're watching right now, I know that you're mentally tough enough and that you have you have the heart to want to succeed. Going it alone, no one wants to do that. And oftentimes, juniors feel very loyal to their coach and all of that, and that's fine. That's fine. But if you are at the status quo and you're not, you don't improve anymore, then you have to start looking at other options. I'm one of very, very few, if not the only one, with the Olympic credentials and the ability to communicate like this over the internet, who does the job as well as I do. When people start coming to me, they're coming to me because they have found a plateau, mental burnout, physical plateau, the ERK scores aren't going any better. And I can help them. I can help your son, your daughter to get better. Some stay with the team, which is fine. So I can improve their technique, but I cannot do anything about overtraining and aggressive training. Some really split with the team because time is of essence. They really, really need to get the ERK score down in order to get to the top school that they deserve to go to, because for a lot of the students that I work with, they really have some amazing grades, okay? If your grades aren't that amazing, you better want to have a really amazing ERK score, no matter what level college you want to go to. It may be a Division II school, but even in the Division II school, you end up having people who have a better ERK score than others, and they are getting picked. And by the way, you're not just rowing against U.S. competition. You are training against international competition. That's the fact of life. You have international students who want that seat that you're shooting for at the university that you love and want to go to. So pain, this is important. Unless you faint, puke, or die, keep rowing, keep working out. You've heard it. If you feel pain, more pain, more gain is wrong. It's wrong. It's physiologically wrong. This is not how you get better. With me, you would not feel that way at all. Yes, there is some pain involved, but trust me, with moderation. ERK technique. Well, that is the lowest hanging fruit to collect. The ERK technique is so abysmal in the United States. I saw it on Crash B's footage. If you want to nail your Crash B, you need to optimize your ERK technique, and the time is now, because you want to really train your subconscious, your neuromuscular system to row the right way. The earlier you start, the chances are that you're going to be doing it come February. And then here we go, focusing on strength. Too often I hear that. I want to get stronger. My ERK score is not good enough. I'm going to start lifting more weights. Well, you'll learn a lot more from me about that once we work together. Very important, Crash B. Crash B, if you nail it, you can go to one of those schools, those lovely, lovely schools, beautiful bodies of water, great history, and hard to get into. But if you nail your Crash B, you're going to be on one of the top recruiting lists for the coaches, be it Division 3, 2, or 1. So that's very, very important to know. And here we go. I think you can see this chart really well. You want to be, where's my little, see my thing has gone, well I'm going to push it over to the bottom. You want to be on the top right corner of this graph. The bulk of highly focused competitors, they're in the bottom there to the left. And some of the rowers who are good in their club or make their first boat, they may be a little bit higher up. That's the middle arrow. But to be honest, in order to get recruited to a university, you have to be at the very top end. Rowers who optimized their potential with key technical nuances and systematic training. This is where you need to be. And the only way you can be there is when you get the information that someone has learned that is top information, elite information. How do you win an Olympic gold medal? Well, the how you win an Olympic gold medal is also how you can get the absolute best, personal best out of yourself on an ergometer. I am the key to that. I love it. That's my passion, to coach people to get to their personal best. This was my 1993 Varsity 8. I was a 4-seat here. It was a life-changing experience. Going to a top school has built me out into a confident individual. The coaching has gotten so much more interesting because we can do so much over the internet. I mean, it is truly amazing how I can see people's rowing. On the ergometer, if you're from the side, I can tell you how your rowing stroke is unfolding and how to improve your weaknesses. It was a training program. I put the training program on my computer screen and I go through the entire training program explaining to you or your son or daughter what the different workouts are and how to feel. And this is where I am very instrumental. I'm not just writing the training program or giving you the technical exercises to do to strengthen your weaknesses. I'm also a person that you can communicate with. I am your go-to with information. You have questions, I have the answers for it. So over and out for now. Watch this final part of the Olympics. I hope you will enjoy it.
Well, he's had a terrific week here, and what an amazing gold medal. Switzerland's first gold medal in Olympic competition since 1928.
I started that. There was nobody who was going to be able to stop Zeno Müller today. It was his day, and my God, didn't he fly those last 500 meters. See this again. Very, very horizontal on the drive back. Good connection through the back, through to the legs.
Please rise. An absolutely stunning victory. Three brilliant scholars. But what a day for the Swiss. To end the day, let's hope that tomorrow's races at least match what we've seen this morning. Not only the quads and eights to look forward to, but also for the first time in Olympic history.